Happy New Year! Welcome back to Bible Discovery. Have you ever wondered about things that seem impossible? Like, how does a fly land on the ceiling? Or, how do these glasses even help me see? They're just glass. And why is the ocean salty anyway? Oh, and why do ice cream and cold drinks give me a brain freeze? What even is a brain freeze? I'm going to put these questions on the screen for you here. Pause the video and talk about them for a minute. So, did anyone come up with any good answers? Those are really perplexing, puzzling, bewildering, befuddled things to think about. Well, guess what? In today's story, Jesus talked about something that was equally confusing. Let's watch it and see what it was.
Jesus was in Jerusalem for the Passover feast. One night, a religious man came to see Jesus. The man's name was Nicodemus. Nicodemus was a Pharisee. He studied and taught God's law, and he tried very hard to obey the law. Nicodemus wanted to know more about Jesus. "Rabbi," he said, "we know that you are a teacher who has come from God. No one could do the miracles you do unless God were with him." Nicodemus had that right. Jesus said, "I tell you, unless someone is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." Now Nicodemus was confused. He thought that keeping all God's laws was how a person got into heaven. Besides, what Jesus said didn't make any sense. "How can anyone be born when he is old?" Nicodemus asked. Jesus said, "A person cannot enter God's kingdom unless he is born of water and the Spirit. Whatever is born of the flesh is flesh, and whatever is born of the Spirit is spirit. When a baby is born, he gets physical life from his parents. Physical life doesn't last forever, but the Spirit gives people a better kind of life, spiritual life, so they can live with God forever." Jesus said, "Don't be surprised I told you that you must be born again." Nicodemus still didn't understand. "How is this possible?" he asked. Jesus said, "When you don't believe what I say about things I've seen on earth, how will you believe what I say about the things I've seen in heaven? Do you remember how Moses raised up the bronze snake in the wilderness? Everyone who looked at it was healed. Like that, the Son of Man will be raised up so that everyone who believes in him will have eternal life." Then Jesus told Nicodemus about God's great plan. Jesus said, "God loved the world in this way. He gave his one and only Son, so that everyone who believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life. God did not send his Son to declare the world guilty, but to save the world. Anyone who believes in him is found not guilty. But anyone who does not believe in him is guilty already." Nicodemus needed new life, eternal life, but he could not do anything to earn it. Eternal life is a gift that comes only from God. God showed his love in this way. He sent his one and only Son to save the world. Everyone who believes in him will not perish, but will have eternal life.
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for questions from kids. Stella from Dallas, Texas asks,
"I recently trusted in Jesus, but I don't feel any different. Was something supposed to happen?"
Well, Stella, we know a lot of things did happen. When you trust in Christ, you are made into a new creature, a new creation. The old is gone, new has come. You're completely forgiven. You're declared righteous. I mean, the list goes on and on. Many different things happen at that nanosecond when you trust in Christ and are forgiven of all your sin. But here's the thing. You said you didn't feel any different. That's understandable. A lot of us don't start experiencing, you know, feeling change or sensing change in our life until some time goes by. This is the process called discipleship and spiritual maturity, that we grow in our faith and we start to see changes happening inside of us and outside of us as we start to act differently. The fruit of the Spirit starts to take shape and we start to sense it more and we see it more and many different things happen. And a lot of times those feelings that we have, that we feel different, will start to follow as well. Now, some people, when they trust in Christ, there may be an immediate feeling, but that's not necessarily what needs to happen for all of us. Here's the big idea. It's not about what we feel, but what we know. And so we go to Scripture and say, all right, if you responded to the gospel, if you trusted in Christ, as I shared before, these things happen. You're forgiven, declared righteous, and so forth. And you can know that, and you have faith in that, and trust in that. You don't put your trust in feelings, because feelings can mislead us at times. There's nothing wrong with feelings, of course, but we can't put our confidence in them. We put our confidence in the Word of God. We put it in truth, what we know to be true, no matter what. So here's a question back for you. What else do you know to be true about God, no matter how you feel?
Wow. Have you ever thought about being born again? It sounds complicated and strange, doesn't it? But Jesus said that unless someone is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. When we're each born as a baby, we were given a physical life, but a physical life doesn't last forever. But the Spirit gives people spiritual life so we can live with God forever. And that is something we should love to think about, isn't it? Well, we'll see you all next week. Have a good week. For God loved the world in this way, loved the world in this way, loved the world in this way.